Here is how you can use ChatGPT for writing better, faster, and more convincingly without losing your authentic voice. I use it to turn days of writing into just a couple hours, and the results sound nothing like AI. ChatGPT is the best writing buddy you could ask for. It's always on, it's always ready to chat, and it's capable of cutting down hours of editing into seconds. And at this point at least, it's free. ChatGPT is a mind-blowingly effective productivity tool made by OpenAI. It's a conversational and highly advanced language model that can understand and generate text while remembering what it told you in the past. Its whole purpose is to generate believable text content. And this is important. It's not a search engine or a research tool. It's purely designed to listen to your questions and then give you a reply that sounds believable. That's a limitation, and it heavily informs how much we can use this tool. ChatGPT has been trained on millions of websites in late 2021, and it comes up with all of its answers from the machine learning algorithms that were used to train it on that particular data. It can write anything, articles, tweets, poems, it can even write code that actually works. It's not all powerful, but it's pretty close. Here's how ChatGPT helps me as a writer. Like most nonfiction authors, I'm an outline writer. I gather ideas, jot down a topic or a title, and then collect random thoughts as bullet points to be organized later. Once I have enough, I organize them into an outline, and then I start writing those paragraphs to flesh out the sections of the outline. And this can take anywhere from 3 hours to 2 days. I reuse that article for my weekly newsletter, my podcast, and my video content, so this writing process comes first. It's very important, and the faster I can get it done, the more time I can spend on everything else. ChatGPT helps me right at the beginning with the idea for my weekly article. I have a huge backlog of ideas, but sometimes I want to think about something new, something current. And at that point, when I struggle to get my creative juices flowing, I ask ChatGPT to come up with 15 topics that would be interesting for founders and creators who are already interested in reading about X, where X is a title from my existing ideas folder. I used a high quantity, quick dismissal approach here. Many of these ideas will be generic, but some will have promise. This is a major feature or drawback of ChatGPT. It comes up with things that sound good, but that doesn't necessarily mean they are good or even make sense for your particular audience. And I will warn you about this several times throughout this video. ChatGPT is built to generate text that sounds believable to as many people as possible. It doesn't mean that it reflects your reality. It can even be very wrong and not reflect any reality. Which is why, even at the idea generating stage, you have to be very careful and check if the things that come out of the AI are actually useful to your audience. So let's go back to the topic list. If none of these work for me, I ask the AI for more, 10 more, and then 10 more topics appear. You can repeat that forever and it won't run out of ideas. Sometimes when things get repetitive, I specify one particular thing to change for the next batch. I say 10 more, but with a stronger focus on business models, for example, and then 10 new matching topics appear. And that is the conversational part of using ChatGPT. You can ask for more or say, make it funnier, and it will recontextualize its output. And by the way, you don't have to say please or thank you to ChatGPT. It doesn't need you to be polite. In fact, it wants you to be precise. The fewer filler words you put in there, the better the outcome will be. And also, if you don't like the results, just tell it to try again. It won't mind. I use this all the time, sometimes just to see how much variation I can get out of it. And if it ever stops writing mid-sentence, by the way, just tell it to continue and it will finish what it started. Okay, so now you have a few topic ideas. Here's how you can use ChatGPT to turn your unstructured thoughts into structured ideas. I call this the condense, explore, attack approach, and it's designed to make the most out of my random notes and thoughts. Let me show you what this means. A few days ago, I was in the middle of cooking a roast, and I was listening to a podcast where the hosts complained about negative reviews, and an idea for an article hit me. So I grabbed my phone and I started talking right into a blank Notion page using speech to text. Random thoughts, ideas, and questions about the topic of reviews, negative reviews in particular. The next day, I fed this transcript verbatim into ChatGPT with the prompt, turn the transcript into a multi-level outline for the topic discussed in the transcript, minimum 3 levels deep. And it did. I got a great outline from that, way less wordy than my notes. This is the condense phase, where I get a concentrated structure out of my train of thought transcript. That usually gets me an outline that is 50% amazing and 50% boring and generic. That's to be expected. ChatGPT tries to be super useful to everyone. That makes most of its content generic, but there are always a few good parts. And I copy those and put them into a fresh Notion page as well. And at that point, I tend to manually brainstorm a few additional ideas myself and then add them to the outline to spice it up a bit. The AI-based suggestions trigger several thoughts that turn into extra bullet points. Next, I take my outline and tell ChatGPT to analyze the transcript and the outline and extract the 3 main ideas. For each idea extracted, provide 2 paragraphs and 1 real-world example. That's the prompt. And this is not for actually writing the article at this point. I do this to see what a generic article would talk about. The things that ChatGPT comes up with here are the points that would likely speak to most people reading the article, so that's valuable to know. But instead of keeping those paragraphs, I rewrite them completely to contain better examples, more relatable phrases, and deeper insights. I figure that if this is the best that this massive AI can come up with, I just have to be a little bit more thoughtful to give it a unique and valuable spin. This process gives me perspective. It shows me what's likely critical to think about and allows me to explore these topics further. Important side note here, I never use ChatGPT's output verbatim in my articles. The way it writes is detectable, and that means 2 things. People would think that I didn't write it, and my work would sound generic. I don't want either of those. So I always use the generated text as a springboard for my own thoughts, never as a replacement. Finally, ChatGPT allows me to do something that used to require other people. It gives me a second perspective. I use it as a devil's advocate of sorts. I ask it, what are the 4 main counterarguments that someone reading this article might come up with? And this is truly magical. ChatGPT acts as if it had written an article on this, and then it attacks its main points from the view of someone who would read this fictitious article. That is so cool. From that, you get several critical perspectives that you can address in your actual first draft. Just like the exploration step, this broadens my horizon around the issue. What am I forgetting? What am I misunderstanding? It's a great way to tighten up and bolster your argument. But again, be aware that all the generated results, the outline, the analysis, and the attacks are created to sound believable. They might not make sense at all if you really look into them. You need to research any claim that this AI makes. And by the way, if you like the tips that I'm sharing in this video, please consider subscribing to my channel. It means the world to me and gives me valuable feedback that you like this video and want to see more of it. And if you're not ready for this kind of a commitment, just boop the like button. That will really help. All right, now comes the actual writing part. I write words and they become paragraphs. I do this by hand. It is after this initial draft that I use ChatGPT. Well, actually, that's not really true. I often ask the tool to give me synonyms or equivalent phrases or grammar corrections during the actual writing process as well. I tend to specify a high number for these answers, like give me 10 synonyms for the phrase small stuff, because I want to have some choice. I ask ChatGPT for colloquialisms, for metaphors, sometimes even for jokes, but those are just the minor details. The powerful stuff comes after that. And those are variations, simplifications, and examples. ChatGPT is incredibly good at rephrasing things. Take a paragraph and tell ChatGPT to rephrase it. This will change the color of your writing in ways you didn't expect and can often create narrative tension where you were just flat before. One trick I use is to emotionally charge the prompt. Rephrase the following paragraph to be very motivational, or rewrite this from the perspective of someone struggling with anxiety. This is a great way to explore different outfits for the points that you want to make. And sometimes you might be over-engineering your writing. Some perfectionists have that problem. ChatGPT can help you if you ask it to simplify this paragraph. It's fun to do this a few times in a row. Often this crystallizes the message into a sentence, sometimes just a phrase. Whenever a section feels a bit dry, I take the paragraph and ask ChatGPT to give me an example for this particular paragraph. It tends to come up with fairly generic ones at first, so you might want to add things like from the beauty industry as a qualifier, or involving a tech company to give the tool more context. These examples can be useful to illustrate your points, but once again, do the research. ChatGPT occasionally comes up with examples that are completely fabricated. I recently wrote about imposter syndrome for a mental health article I was working on, and I asked ChatGPT to show me a few scientific articles to read. It came up with a long list, half of which were completely made up. Some had real authors but fake titles, others were completely fake. It pains me to say this, but do your own research here. ChatGPT is trained to sound convincing. It is constantly gaslighting you by creating believable text. It comes up with reasonably sounding but non-existent resources. Never use those in your work without checking if they actually exist. Don't use it for legal advice or medical help. Language models like ChatGPT are incapable of telling the truth. They don't have a concept of true or false. They don't have the means to judge. ChatGPT is deliberately stupid. It will even admit that when you ask it. It's very submissive. You can inform ChatGPT that 2 plus 2 equals 5, and it will believe you, and it will give you that result next time you ask. This tool will do everything to try and convince you that you are right. So be careful and deliberately filter out all the stuff that sounds fishy, because it probably is. And consider that whatever words you use in your prompt will be considered to be useful and true by the AI. So be wary if it comes up with factually wrong things just to make you feel good. But if you use ChatGPT to transform your existing texts, like for summaries, it'll be great. That brings me to my final tip. When you have written your article, paste the whole thing into ChatGPT and ask it to generate an engaging description for YouTube from this article. Save these summaries and then use them for your social media work. You can even ask ChatGPT to turn the article into a Twitter thread for you, and this will save you a lot of time as well. And please ignore the hashtags. ChatGPT, at least right now, is really bad with hashtags. So there you have it. From idea generation throughout the draft to social media snippets, ChatGPT can be a really helpful writing buddy that's always ready to expand, simplify, and provide variety for your writing. Make sure you apply good judgment to its output. Please do that, and you'll have a great tool at your disposal that can jumpstart your creativity and provide outside perspectives within seconds, all day long, every day. Have fun being a cyborg writer.